guess where I am. I'm looking at clear blue water in Rocapina Bay, Corsica. I'm on a train from Melbourne to Uluru, Ayers Rock. I'm in Budapest, figuring out what to do with this money I took from my partner, my treacherous, no-good, one-time love. None of them. All of them. I haven't decided yet. But I'm going to have to. It was Ali told me about Fraser. Much later, I phoned him and arranged to meet. You can make me disappear.
Yes.
A new life.
Yes.
Start again, where no one will find me.
If that's what you want.
Yes. It is. You choose your life and you hardly know it. The things, the people, the places, the work. All things you've become while you weren't paying attention. Once, Ali said,
you know, this isn't fun anymore. I mean, imagine your life being fun instead of a race you hadn't trained for.
In your dreams, you think, what if it wasn't this life I was living, but another one? What if there are other lives to be lived than mine? Other lives to be lived by me? And you start dreaming of that other life. But the truth is, you'd never actually leave, would you? Start again? You'd never actually do it. But I would, it turns out. I did. Not much of an office. Printer, a phone, a laptop.
I have an assistant, Sam. Sam is going to prepare some documents, things you'll need to sign.
You must be busy. Number of people looking for a way out these days.
We don't help many people. A lot of people think they want to disappear until I tell them what it takes.
What does it take?
Commitment. It takes commitment.
Okay.
Now, when we first met, we talked about a name. And this will be the name we'll put on all your documents, your credit cards. And you said...
Anita Lunst. Don't ask me where it came from. I've no idea. You don't like it?
No, it's fine. Sam liked it. She said you remind her of a teacher she had at school. She looks flaky, but she's probably tough, she said. Or she looks tough, but she's probably flaky.
I've taught people like her.
I need to know a couple more things. When people disappear, there are, on average, 12 people they leave behind who miss them. I need to know who those people are. I need to know about your family. Your father's dead, you said?
Yes.
Your mother?
No.
Kathryn?
It's not important.
You have brothers, sisters?
Not any longer.
Dependents? Children?
I know. No.
You're close friends?
Yes, but not close, no.
Most people who come to me don't really understand it's a no-return kind of thing.
Trust me, I do.
What they feel when it's over is grief. That's all. There is nothing left, nothing to go back to. You miss the birthdays, the weddings, the funerals. You are entirely alone. I have to know you know that. Your family.
It's private.
No, it isn't.
I can't help you.
Well, then I can't...
You've got the word freedom tattooed on your arm.
Yes.
You're Fraser. You make people disappear.
I clean up after them. People have a lot of stuff to clean up.
You used to find people who'd jump bail, didn't you? Then you crossed over, joined the other side, started helping people to escape.
It's a skill.
Oh, it's not just a skill. It's an odd kind of a job.
What do you want to do?
I'm just trying to work out if I can trust you.
Oh, that's funny. Now, you're going to have to help me.
There was a fire. I lost my boy. I hadn't seen his father for years. After a long while, I had another man. We wanted a child. He left me. My father's dead. I never see my mother. I keep busy at a job I detest. My old life is gone. I have no memories. I feel grief.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.